When we envision nature, it's possible that many things come to mind. Maybe it's blue skies, rugged canyons, or vibrant tropical reefs. The Earth is full of breathtaking landscapes. But when we think of life, it's hard to do so without plants. They exist just about everywhere sunlight reaches Earth, from freezing cold tundras to scorching hot deserts. Additionally, plants perform vital functions like purifying the air and providing nutrients and shelter to other living things. But what exactly is a plant? And how do we tell different kinds of plants apart? In today's lesson, we'll be exploring this topic as we describe the characteristics of plants and explain the differences between the four main plant groups. Let's get into it. In our last lesson, we learned that taxonomy is the science of naming and classifying living things. Life is divided into three large domains, one of which is eukarya, and within this domain there are four kingdoms, and one of those kingdoms is, you guessed it, plants. We'll start by defining exactly what a plant is. Now, I know you're probably thinking, I know what a plant is. They're green and they have leaves and stuff. So here's a challenge for you. Is this a plant? Or is this? Trickier than you thought, huh? Well, classifying plants can be tricky for scientists as well, which is why plants are categorized based on four key characteristics. These characteristics are as follows. All plants are eukaryotic, which means plant cells store their DNA in a nucleus. Additionally, plant cells have cell walls, which are rigid structures that help cells keep their shape. Plants are multicellular, which means they are made of many cells put together. And finally, all plants perform photosynthesis, which is a series of reactions occurring in the presence of sunlight that creates sugar. With these four characteristics, we can easily tell the plant fakers from the real plants. For example, because all plants are multicellular, algae, which are commonly referred to as a seaweed or kelp, are not considered plants because they can be unicellular or multicellular. Additionally, mushrooms are not plants because they can't perform photosynthesis. An orange tree, however, is a plant because it checks off all the boxes of our four key plant characteristics. Okay. Now we've established what a plant is, but that still leaves us with thousands of plant species to further categorize. Luckily, we have the taxonomic system to guide us. The plant kingdom is divided into four phyla, or groups, which we'll refer to as non-vascular plants, seedless vascular plants, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. In taxonomy, scientists typically categorize different groups using specific traits or characteristics. One of these characteristics in plants is the presence or absence of a vascular system, which is a designated system for transporting materials within a plant. If you've ever looked at a leaf carefully, you may have noticed thin lines within the leaf called veins. These lines are part of the plant's vascular system, which delivers nutrients and water to keep the leaf healthy. Non-vascular plants are unique in that they do not have a vascular system. Instead, relying on diffusion through non-specialized cells to transport materials. Additionally, they lack roots and have unusual stems and leaves, which gives them an appearance that is very different from most other plants. Non-vascular plants reproduce using spores, which are tiny reproductive cells that contain genetic information to create a new plant. These spores are then carried off to a new area by the wind or a passing critter, where they take up residence and begin to grow. Some examples include liverworts, hornworts, and mosses, which you can find covering the ground, trees, or rocks in places all over the earth. The three remaining phyla all have vascular systems and roots, which means scientists use different characteristics to classify them. We'll start with seedless vascular plants, which, as their name implies, are unlike other vascular plants in that they don't produce seeds. Instead, they reproduce using spores, which are released from the underside of their leaves. In addition to releasing spores, these leaves are unique in that they have fronds divided into leaflets. You can think of these leaves as big leaves made out of smaller leaves connected together. This gives seedless vascular plants, commonly referred to as ferns, a signature look that makes them easy to recognize. The last two phyla we'll discuss reproduce using seeds, which are created during fertilization, or when pollen from two plants is mixed together. Gymnosperms are vascular plants, named after their naked seeds, which simply means the seeds aren't enclosed in a fruit. Instead, seeds are stored in cones, which are a signature feature of these plants. When the cones are carried away by the wind or animals to a new place, the fertilized seeds sprout and begin to grow. Gymnosperms have waxy and needle-like leaves, and most are evergreen, which means they keep their leaves all year round. Some common examples include pine trees, fir trees, spruces, and junipers. This brings us to our final phylum, angiosperms, which are vascular and include all grasses and flowering plants. Like gymnosperms, angiosperms also reproduce using seeds. However, their seeds are created within flowers and enclosed in fruits. And this unique combination serves a variety of purposes. Flowers attract pollinators, such as bees, wasps, and hummingbirds, by producing nectar, which is a form of sugar water. The hungry pollinators drink their fill and carry pollen to other plants, which allows the mixing of pollen, or fertilization, to occur. So that's a job well done, right? What's the point of all the fruit? Well, when animals and insects eat these tasty treats, undigested seeds are deposited far away from the original plant. This allows the next generation to grow in a new area, reducing overcrowding. In this way, flowers and the fruits they produce assist angiosperms throughout every phase of the reproductive process. The next time you have the opportunity to enjoy the outdoors, take a look at the various plants around you. What characteristics do they all share as members of the plant kingdom? And what characteristics makes them different from each other? You might be surprised by what you find. And with that, we have concluded our lesson on the plant kingdom. We've learned that plants are multicellular eukaryotic organisms that have cell walls and perform photosynthesis to create their own food. Additionally, we've learned that the plant kingdom is divided into four phyla, or groups. Non-vascular plants include plants without vascular systems or roots, such as mosses. Seedless vascular plants, commonly referred to as ferns, have segmented leaves and reproduce using spores. Gymnosperms, on the other hand, reproduce using seeds stored in cones, are typically evergreen, and have needle-like leaves. Finally, angiosperms include all flowering plants and grasses, which reproduce using seeds that are created in flowers and are enclosed in fruits. In our next lesson, we'll take our first look at the animal kingdom, where we'll explore the core characteristics of animals and the various groups that they are divided into. Until then, I'm Tony, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep learning and don't ever stop wondering.